diaphragm.com.
All right. Well, in this video, we're going to discuss hemoperitoneum in the right upper quadrant. Since this is the first window where we're discussing hemoperitoneum, before I show you what that looks like, I want to discuss in general what free fluid looks like on ultrasound, as hemoperitoneum is a form of free fluid. And this will apply generally to ultrasound and is important because there's lots of fluid within the body, and just because you see fluid on ultrasound doesn't mean it's pathologic. And the concept's pretty simple. If I have a cup and I pour water into that cup, then that water fills up the cup and the fluid takes the shape of the container which it's in. Similarly in the body, if I have the bladder, for example, and I have a fluid-filled bladder, then that fluid is going to take the shape of the bladder. And notice how it's generally a geometric shape with smooth borders, and it's within the walls of that container. Well, free fluid's different. If I have two cups, for example, sitting on a table, and I pour fluid in between the cups, it's free, it's not within the cups, it's going to go down to the most dependent areas that it can. And it's not taking the shape of the cup because it's in between the cups. In fact, its shape is outlined by the cups. Well, let's say I have the bladder and bowel in the body, and I have fluid in between bladder and bowel. So that fluid is free. It's going to outline the bowel on one side and the bladder on the other. And so you notice that these shapes are more sharp. They're not geometric, they have sharp borders, and the fluid will go to the most dependent area in that theoretical space. So with that in mind, then, we can ask ourselves several questions when we're trying to determine if this is free fluid. The first is we just have to have proper orientation, meaning our transducer has to be oriented correctly, we have to know our anatomy, and then know, is this fluid in a pathological place or is this fluid in a normal anatomic place? The second and third questions kind of go together. The second one is there an echogenic wall that's surrounding the fluid? That would let us know that this is fluid within a cavity, not free fluid. And then what shape does the fluid take? Is it smooth and geometric, suggesting it's within a cavity, or does it have sharp borders and it's going to the dependent areas of a theoretical space? And then the last one is there movement of the fluid? And specifically looking for, is there peristalsis? Because if there's peristalsis and movement of the fluid, that suggests that this is within bowel and not free fluid. All right, well, now on to looking for hemoperitoneum in the right upper quadrant. And just as a reminder, we're going to be scanning in the right flank, approximately mid-axillary line, with the indicator pointing superiorly or towards the right axilla. And we're going to see diaphragm here. We're going to see liver here. And we're going to see right kidney here. And we're going to be focusing on the interfaces between liver and diaphragm, in the subphrenic space, and between the liver and right kidney in Morrison's pouch, and then at the inferior tip here, where the right pericolic gutter meets Morrison's pouch. And this is a video clip of what normal is, just to remind us. Here's liver, here's kidney, we see diaphragm here, and this would be the subphrenic area that we're going to focus on, and then we're going to focus on Morrison's pouch, and where the right pericolic gutter meets Morrison's pouch. So that's normal. Now this is our first abnormal. What's different here? Well, if we focus on the subphrenic area underneath the diaphragm, we see this hypoechoic fluid collection under the diaphragm above the liver. And the echo texture of the liver looks different. In this case, the patient had a liver laceration with hemoperitoneum in the right subphrenic space. So this is a positive FAST exam. Moving down to Morrison's pouch, in this patient we see liver, right kidney, and in Morrison's pouch, between those two, we see an anechoic fluid collection, free fluid collection, between those organs. So this is hemoperitoneum in Morrison's pouch. This is a positive FAST. In this example, we're down to the pericolic gutter, where it meets Morrison's pouch at the inferior tip of the liver. And we see this anechoic fluid collection. And as the patient is breathing in and out, the diaphragm is moving up and down, and the liver is moving in and out of view here. So this is hemoperitoneum, the inferior tip of the liver. This is a positive FAST exam. So now that we've seen video clips of this, let's just review our anatomy again. Diaphragm, liver, right kidney, and Morrison's pouch right here has positive free fluid, hemoperitoneum. This here is liver. This here is the inferior pole of the right kidney. This here is bowel. See it outlined here. And here we see fluid in the right pericolic gutter coming up to where it meets Morrison's pouch. Now keep in mind, there may not be that much fluid as seen on the previous examples, but we still should be able to detect this. Here's an example where here's liver, here's kidney, and in between them, we have a small amount of free fluid, but this is still a positive FAST exam. Here we have inferior portion of the liver, the right kidney, and where Morrison's pouch meets the pericolic gutter, we see a small amount of free fluid. Again, this is still a positive FAST exam. Now, those were all true positives. There are false positives and some pitfalls that you could fall into in the right upper quadrant. So I want to go over those. On the top left here, we see the gallbladder. You see an echogenic wall surrounding the gallbladder, kind of a pear-like shape, and there's fluid within it. But as we talked about in the beginning of the free fluid discussion, this is within the container, so it takes the shape of the container and has echogenic walls surrounding it. If you aim too anteriorly in the right upper quadrant, you'll begin to see the gallbladder. And this is not free fluid, but fluid within the gallbladder. The middle example down here is a case of perinephric fat. We have the right kidney here. We have the liver here. And in between the two, we see this small black strip. This is perinephric fat, though. It's usually not completely anechoic, although it can be. It's usually more dark gray. But you'll also notice that there's a white line on both sides of it. And this differs in appearance to what we saw here. Here we have the lining of the kidney. We see free fluid in Morrison's pouch, but there's not another hypoechoic lining on the other side of it. And that's how you can tell the difference. And perinephric fat tends to be a small strip. And then this last one is the case of fluid within bowel in the right upper quadrant. This could be the colon at the hepatic flexure. And again, notice our principles of free fluid. This is not free as it's within the bowel and you see the invaginations of the lining of the bowel and you'll see fluid within it. So here's the wall of the bowel. This is fluid within, not free fluid. So that is hemoperitoneum in the right upper quadrant. In the next video, we will discuss hemoperitoneum in the left upper quadrant.